Somebody's in the second room. They're up there now. We got somebody up on the second room up there.
The 105 has one of the alarm box up.
He's saying there's somebody in the second room. So they had an early morning fire over here on Warren Street. A lot of people are going to be displaced, and it's pretty cold out today. According to saying that, they're saying that somebody's still in the building there. They're pulling somebody out there saying. Apparently they got people still inside the building.
Rockstar, US 5215, 433.
He's striking a second alarm. So they're striking a second alarm for this address, 314. Calling multiple ambulances down here for multiple people in the building. Apparently there's people still in the building while they're fighting the fire. So they're letting the people go inside the McDonald's that are being displaced. So they'll be going inside McDonald's to warm up until the MBTA bus arrives.
If somebody near the ambulance, if they have a couple blankets, if they can just bring them over here.
They're calling multiple ambulances down here.
Cover station 14, 436. Driver, everything okay? 436. 24, attention exit 17. Cover station 24, 436. Attention ladder 15, cover station 14. Attention ladder 15, cover station 14, 437. Attention ladder 17, cover station 33. Attention ladder 17, cover station 33, 437.
Bravo 913, will two vans, 215 down here, 6 vans. We could probably use one, we got the McDonald's open, and people are inside right now.
You're still bringing people out of the building. A lot going on at one time. Channel 2 is a fire ground channel. Channel 7 is the only cameraman down here at this time.
My favorite TV station.
Channel 7?
They can go off of the Tango 55
in
McDonald's and try to
identify
the people
that are
in there.
There's a lot going on right now. A lot of people are burnt and coming out injured. You got a little geyser over here, water squirting out. You gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah,
He came in as, you know, as soon as the first engine got on the scene, he called for a reinforcement, so he automatically knew he had a situation on his hands.
Roxbury, US Box 2151,
we're
in Clifford Street.
440. It's a cold day out today too. It's very, very cold. I'm not too sure the temperature, but it's has to be down in the teens. Probably 18 degrees or so. For the most part, all the people that have been displaced, they're in McDonald's over here warming up. I wasn't prepared for this one, but Ladder 15 arriving.
Attention ladder 17, travel station 14. Attention ladder 17, travel station 14, 443.
This one is very important when you see a fire truck or ambulance with the sirens on to move out of its way. What's up, Dave? Doing? All right. Somebody got a drone up in the sky. I'm not too sure who got the drone up in this guy. Might be Boston Fire. Right above my head is a one of DJI drones up in the sky there. The Boston Fire Department utilizes drones pretty often, so that could be theirs. For the most part, the fire is knocked down. There is some smoky and hot spots. I believe they got everybody out of the building. They're still checking. They're still checking. Alright guys, if anything else comes up, I'll get back to you. Pretty serious event. Possible they may have a deceased body inside. I'm not sure of details. What's up, buddy? How you doing?
How are you?
Good to see you. They called Kilo 6 and Kilo 7 to respond. They're gonna do an investigation. Boston police brought their van over to keep some of the people warm in their van as well. Most of the families are inside of the McDonald's. It's early morning fire around 4:15 or so it was struck. This all happened so fast. Couldn't even get all the details out. I believe engine 14 was the first on scene, and they had smoke and fire showing automatically. They, asked reinforcements. And like I said, it's about, last I checked, it was like 13 degrees out right now, so it's pretty cold. Boston Fire Department, I believe that's Boston Fire Department's drone. There's a drone that's, gotcha.
46, a structure fire, 314 Warren Street, Roxbury, 46, a structure fire, 314 Warren Street, Roxbury, 052151 Warren and Clifford
Street, 501. Give you the idea of all the manpower they needed to, a lot of manpower.
A structure fire, 314 Warren Street, Roxbury, 21. A structure fire, 314 Warren Street, Roxbury, US Box 2151 Warren and Clifford Street, 501.
I'm not sure if anybody has him or her within eyesight, but we just get the fire command's name for the report on the inside the McDonald's. anyone else that saw fire come in, can you get the name?
Like I said, it hasn't been confirmed, but listening on the fire ground tour earlier, it sounded like they found the deceased body inside of the building. Now, I can't confirm that, but that's what it sounded like, basically what I heard. Hey, what's happening? Like I said, it's a very, very cold morning, like 13 degrees out. Just about everybody's going to be coming down here. This is probably one of the most serious ones that we had in a while.
A structure fire, 314 Warren Street. Roxbury, C2. A structure fire, 314 Warren Street.
Roger, here at 521514 in Clifford Street, 504. Just took another person out in the from the McDonald's over there. So ladder 15 is going to be pulling out of here shortly. This is going to probably be a pretty much all morning event, if it is what I believe it is. And this went down to a two alarm. It was a two alarm fire. It went down to. So for the most part, the fire is knocked down. The majority of the fire trucks will probably pull out. They probably have a few standby as a precautionary measure, like engine 14 and ladder 26. They'll probably be the two that remain. They are the primary units. You guys can see that drone that's like right, there's a drone right there.
Ladder 17, enter known medical, 25 Warren Street. Roxbury, ladder 17, and a very low level. Roxbury, US 52127 Devon and Warren Street, 507.
Channel 5 is on scene.
This is Delta Service Car EDC on.
Delta 499.
499, they're gonna need you on Channel 3. They had a car and they have victims. They need you to get to the hospital. It's gonna be.
Check on the victims at MPH. Okay, and I was just informed there might be two at DMC. We go up to four, and then possibly one more.
Looks like it was like a total of five or six victims they took out.
Okay, I will check on that. I believe there's four that were transported and one not viable. Two to MGH, but I'll check with EMS. Yeah, I've got, I think through the confusion, I've got up a little bit, I've gotten a couple of them. Very open, BFD, the Mass General, all had transported. Okay, sir, I'll confirm and I'll let you know. Thank you very much.
Not too sure how many families are going to be displaced, but it looks like at least four or five. It could be more. Quite a few people inside of McDonald's, so it's probably going to be quite a few families being displaced.
Fire alarm, M5.
M5.
Fire alarm, M5.
I've
been at the fire scene.
At the fire scene, M5,
511. 902, sir, did we get anybody to check that alarm, or is that still outstanding? Delta Rapid, took care of it.
Hey!
Thanks very much. And any B2 units, make sure we're swapping
hey,
out. Stay warm.
Yes, sir, fire chief. Hey.
Victor 9. A Victor unit call?
A Victor 926, sir. You can show me a route to Warren Street.
So apparently there's one one body still inside of the building.
Two to BMC, one to Brigham, one to MGH.
Great, thank you. And although I appreciate those units helping us out, getting IDs and everything. They can, if you could pass on for any outside districts, they can put them in 26 or contact the scribe.
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Do I still have a Bravo 660 or 661 up Mass and Cass area, or they all know the fire?
This is why everybody came down here when they heard it.
We have to be standing by that we can get more vehicles so they won't.
I have it, sir. Okay. Do I have a unit on the fire not committed that can have to BMC to check on the victim?
Just about everybody dropped what they were doing and came over here.
One all, we can get out. Alright, one all, I'll put you on it.
Like I said, this is probably going to be an all-day event for the most part. Boston Police are going to have to do an investigation as well as Boston Fire Department.
499, if you can get info from the victim of all the fires, what's over to Brigham.
So what we have now, I believe to be like at least four or maybe five victims that were transported to hospitals. I think there's a fifth victim that's been transferred as well. That's why it's very, very important to have working carbon monoxide and smoke detectors. I think I said it in one of my videos earlier. Now is the time to check your dryer vents, your carbon monoxide detectors, your smoke detectors, and make sure they are actually working. And every household should have at least one fire extinguisher in there. Deal is going to be the media staging area. Like I said, this is an early morning fire that happened around like, I want to say like 4:15 or so. It is believed to be that one person has deceased. All right, guys, that's what we have so far. If anything else comes up, I can't hear you. Say that again. You want a video from me? Just want to be on YouTube. Oh. External Affairs Porter, probably in the next couple of hours. Oh. Say it again. External Affairs Porter. External Affairs Porter. Yep. You'll see it on YouTube probably in the next, I don't know, maybe a few hours. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yep, no problem. A lot of people asking me about the videos. I just post them up there. They can do what they want once they see it up there. I try to get as much details as possible. So all the fire investigators are down here. Boston Police is sending their detectives and investigators down here as well. Boston EMS is standing by, you know, as a precautionary measure. Boston Gas is going to cut the gas to the building as soon as they get a chance. They do have a media staging area. I'm not too sure what they're going to say at this point, but there is a media staging area at Dale and Warren. I'll probably head over there later on just to see what they're, if they let out any press release or anything. Like I said, it's a very, very cold day. It's about 13 degrees. Unfortunately, this had to happen.
ladder 14, cover station 37. Attention ladder 14, cover station 37, 522.
So ladder 26 is preparing to head out. Like I said, Boston Fire Department respond to a lot of structure fires. Some of them are false alarms and some of them are not, but when they do respond, they treat all the same as if it is, and they, you know, they're getting out as quick as they can, as fast as they can, you know. And ladder 26 and the engine 14, like, they did a pretty good job getting down here. They're right down by Dougley, but, you know, they got here quick as they can.
Engine
10, Enterzone 94, 700
Atlantic
Avenue, Boston. I'm not too sure if the mayor is gonna come out. I know the fire chief is already here. He's already here.
Victor Delta 241. Myself and the 100, we're en route to Warren Street Fire. I have that.
Like I said, this happened around 4:15 in the morning. I'm not too sure what caused it. It looked like it was on the second floor. I'm not too sure if that's where it originated from or not.
Their fire command is requesting you to the front of the building. Yep, right there.
Little geyser over there. They called for a sander to put some salt down for Boston Public Works. But you see the, from the hose, it's all icicles over there now. If you guys can see that. It's all very slippery and icy. Kind of give you the idea of what the fire department has to deal with in this kind of frigid weather. Icicles coming off the building.
Victor
96,
your copy.
All right, guys, we'll hang around. If anything else comes up, we'll get back to you. Like I said, this is going to be pretty much an all morning event, you know.
Oh, I'm at 210.
310.
We're at 1230. Tango Echo 502 Ocean North. Good morning.
Substation, report in front of the police desk. Security is on scene now.
They're going to need you in front of the building as well when you get a chance.
How am I going to get over there?
Yeah, once they move the trucks out the way. So just hang around, don't go too far.
Okay, well, alright. I have to send somebody back out here.
Okay, just do the best you can then.
Alright.
Okay. He said he's off duty in a few minutes, but he sent somebody else back out.
Operation.
He said he's off duty in a few minutes, but he'll send somebody else back out. It's a lot of ice.
Anyone can contact the Victor 926 to see if he can respond to the front of the building. 3-1-1.
Victor 818, I'll relay that to him.
Did he say somebody else on the phone?
Yeah, that's what he said. I told him to hang around, but he said he gets off in a few minutes. Yeah. You see if you can put maybe make a quick pass or something. In a situation like this, you could stay on the clock for another hour and your boss should have no problem giving you overtime with that. Like, I don't see why the city of Boston would not allow that, you know. He's seen that he's already on site. Give him an extra hour or 2 hours overtime. Unless he's already on double, and that could be something different too. You said the same thing? You know, he tried though, right? Yeah, he thought you could do was try. I told him the same thing, but he said he gotta go. I'm like, okay. I can't make him stay.
Yeah.
But in situations like that, the city of Boston should give him the overtime.
Yeah,
automatically. Yeah. But it is what it is.
Fire line 49.
And that's considered an emergency situation. They should have certain protocol how they deal with that. We got to talk to the mayor's office and see. Warren and Townsend, they're going to stage at. There's a lot of, you know, it is a lot of ice over there.
The 926 has that message. She's making her way over there shortly. And I'm going to start off at BMC.
Thank you, sir.
Victor
956 or 856. I'm looking at it as well.
So this is pretty much going to be an all day event. See an ice forming on the ground. Anything that's wet is pretty much going to be ice. See, the families are still inside of the McDonald's over here. That was nice of McDonald's to do that because, you know, these people definitely need a shelter. Tower ladder 10. Boston Fire Department have a very difficult job. It's definitely not easy, that's for sure. Guys, anything else comes? What's up, man? How you doing? Good to see you, my man. How you been? How you been, man? Good. What's happening?
How you been, brother?
Good.
Chilling.
Oh, do my videos, yeah. Yeah.
Everything.
Good. Good to see you. I didn't want to bother you while you was working.
Listen, man, say whatever you need to say, you know me.
Good to see you, man. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, you know, everything's well?
Good, yeah.
Good. The family's doing good?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Good, that's what I like to hear.
My daughter's a firefighter in Randolph.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Get out of here. How long has she been out there?
Second year.
Good for her, man. Yep. Tell her congratulations and tell her to stay safe.
There you go.
Whatever she do, stay safe.
All right, Jeff, I'll talk to you.
Good to see you,
then. All right, now. Now 810, they do a lot of volunteer work for the fire department and the police work. They do an outstanding job out there as well. I don't know if you guys ever seen them in action, but they come to all of the major fires in the city and neighboring towns, and they do a great job out there.
Fire alarm, carry call from the city. Kyle Reese, we're also returning from the second, 5:30.
He put as much salt down as he could put down there. He may have to come back and have someone else come back to finish off the rest of it. He did say he gets off in the next 15 minutes or so. So I guess he did the best he could at the time that he had. See all the icicles from the buildings, from the water.
We just arrived at Engine 37 Porter, the 126 is back. We're returning.
Okay, Ladder 14, we have that 530.
There's a lot of ice out there. It's, you know, all you do is the best you can with that. Now you guys get to see what the Boston Fire Department has to really deal with in extreme temperatures.
You guys missed one, huh?
Oh yeah, how you doing, man?
What's up?
I try to get them off if I can.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're tough to get to though.
Yeah.
You guys do a great job out there. Keep up the good work.
Thanks, you too.
All right. And firefighters, they don't get as much credit as they deserve, you know. These guys are physically running into burning buildings when other people are running out. And they're risking their lives to save other people's lives. And I don't think they get all of the credit they deserve. You don't really see the work they do until you see the work they do.
199.
Alright guys, I'm going to hang around for a little bit. If anything else comes up, I see if I give you more details, but that's what we have so far. Maybe a second video I do for the later on. Right now, they're wrapping up all their gear. They're going to head up out of here. The Austin investigators will conduct an investigation. Boston police homicide detectives and the other group will conduct their investigation. And we'll go from there. I'll give you one more walk around before I cut this one off. It's about 13 degrees out, so it's very, very cold out here. If you're not bundled up nice and warm, you will definitely know about it. They got some people sitting on the T-bus as well. See all the fire investigators, you know, these are all the officials over here. Channel 7 is warming up inside the van there, and Channel 5 is warming up as well. On scene as well. They're probably going to cut the power. Usually when they have a fire like this, they cut the water, they cut the power, they cut the gas, you know, for various different reasons. the most part, the fire is knocked down. Deputy Chief. Just about everybody's responding out here. Situation was pretty much all hands on deck. Boston Fire Department did a great job, fast response. What's up, buddy? How you doing? Yeah, it's cold out here. Very, very cold out here. What you been up to? It's like 13 degrees, man.
It's gonna be a long fucking day.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be all morning, pretty much. Yeah.
You can't even find out who's on
site. I don't think they're on site, but most of the residents are inside McDonald's.
Who is it? Who owns it?
I don't know who owned that particular building. Maybe check one of the residents inside. They don't know. No, there's only, I think only one.
Can you give me the location of the at the scene?
He's saying it, well, he said there's maybe two bodies inside there. This is gonna be a pretty serious event that took place. This is probably one of the most serious fires we had in quite a while in the city of Boston.
Table.
Okay, thanks. Appreciate it. Guys, if anything else comes up, I get back to you. Right now, it's going to be an ongoing investigation.
We are staged at Townsend and Warren.
For the most part, Boston Fire Department is going to be cleaning up out of here. Boston Police and Boston Fire will be conducting an investigation throughout the day. How you doing, man?
Good to see you. Do you stand on that sidewalk with
sure.
me, please?
Good to see you. You remember me, do you?
Probably.
I remember you.
Okay.
Good to see you. All right, man. Alright guys, if anything else comes up, we'll get back to you. Right now they'll be doing pretty much an ongoing investigation. Catch you guys on the next one. I'll probably do a secondary video on this, not too sure, but we'll see.